All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video. Today we are talking about Texas reopening up and what this means for DoorDash drivers, because I think this could be a sign of the near end in the future. Just kidding. I think DoorDash is going to continue on as it normally is, but I think there's going to be some serious changes, and I think there's going to be some serious decline in how many orders are coming in. So basically, as Texas reopens up, I believe that more and more states are going to start to reopen themselves, meaning that more restaurants are eventually going to be completely open for people to go to, which means I think there's going to be a significant amount less orders than there was over the last few, or over the last year or so. So if you guys remember about a year ago or so, for me at least, and I'm sure many other Dashers, because I know a lot of friends that Dash, it was very hard to get orders. A lot of people would sit there and try to log in. You'd have to like swipe, refresh, swipe, refresh, swipe, refresh, and then as soon as a shift would pop up, you'd have to click it real quick and then just go through, and like, that's how it was for like pretty much a year for after I started DoorDashing. And I think that it's going to go back to how it was, because I believe DoorDash over the past year hired so many new drivers that now it's going to be way oversaturated compared to what it used to. So what this means for anyone who's a DoorDash driver, especially if you're only a DoorDash driver and you are not on multiple platforms, this should be a signal for you guys to get onto different platforms, or to look for different money ventures, or different ways of making passive income, or any sort of side hustles. Maybe there's some new apps, one's called like Roadie. Maybe you could become a Lyft driver, or any kind of rideshare, or something like that. I would suggest to anyone out there who is specifically just a DoorDash, or just a Postmates, or just Grubhub, if you guys only have one app right now, do not feel safe, because, I mean, maybe I'm wrong, maybe I'm right. Comment down below, let me know where you guys are dashing, what state you're in, or what state you guys have dashed in before. Let me know in the comments down below so I can see where everyone's dashing in, and then we can kind of get a grasp of like where my audience mostly is. But for my prediction, because a lot of people have asked me to make a prediction on how long this like COVID thing is gonna last for, like, because we've essentially had unlimited amount of shifts for the last year. You know, it has not been a problem to log in and just start driving. Basically, like, the most I've ever had to wait was like 5 minutes, and then I can log right in. I think that's coming to an end, and there's gonna be, I would say there's probably 100, 150% of the amount of Dashers that we need for 100%. God damn it, I suck at math. Anyways, I think there's about 1.5 to 2 drivers to every one driver that DoorDash is going to need going from here on, because I really don't think that it's gonna be as popping as it used to be. People are gonna see that restaurants are finally open, they can start going in, COVID's not gonna be as like present as it normally is, and I think as one state opens, it's gonna be a trend, and we're gonna see a lot more opening. At least we're gonna see a lot of restrictions coming up, and there's gonna be more like 50% capacity instead of like 35% capacity, and then so on and so on. So this is just a warning for any of you guys who are just driving on one specific platform. Beware that you might lose a significant amount of income, especially if what I'm saying is true. And I'm just going based off of what it used to be like and how many drivers DoorDash hired this year, because I know they hired like 2 to 3 times as many as they used to have. So just be careful. This is your only way of making money. This, take this as a warning from some random dude on YouTube, that you should probably get at least, at minimum, a second way of a gig, or like maybe get one like Instacart, or again like rideshare, that's completely separate and has nothing to do with delivery driving. So that's just my advice on, that's just my advice, guys. So take it or leave it. If you guys don't want to, no worries. I'm not always right, and in fact, I could definitely be very wrong, you know? But that's just my prediction. So if you guys enjoy these videos at all, please consider smashing the like button and subscribe to the channel. We'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.